Hello and welcome to the next video lecture of stability, that is root stability criteria. And in this lecture we are going to see some special cases of root stability criteria. So as we know, the necessary and sufficient condition for a system to be stable is all terms in the first column of roots array must have the same sign. Consider the system with the characteristic equation s raised to 5 plus 2 s raised to 4 plus 3 s cube plus 6 s square plus 2 s plus 1 is equal to 0. Determine the stability of system using the roots criteria. So first we write down this equation as it is. So let us denote it by f of s. So that is equal to s raised to 5 plus 2 s raised to 4 plus 3 s square plus 6 s square plus 2 s plus 1 is equal to 0. Next step is to make the roots array. Okay, so to find the even and odd coefficient means first a term is a0, then a1, a2, a3 like this. So we call it as even and odd coefficients, and we write the even coefficients in the first row and odd coefficients in the second row. So likewise we form the roots array in which at the left side the s powers are written: s raised to 5, s raised to 4, s raised to 3, s raised to 2, s raised to 1 and s raised to 0. Then let us write down the coefficients. That is, first coefficient of s raised to 5 is 1, then coefficient of s raised to 3 is 3, coefficient of s raised to 1 is 2. Okay, so it will be in the first row. Then in the second row we will write the coefficient of s raised to 4, that is 2, then coefficient of s raised to 2 is 6, and coefficient of s raised to 0 is 1. Okay, then we will calculate the value of next term, that is c1. So for that we have to consider these values 1, 3, 2, 6, and then we will calculate like this. C1 will be equal to 2 into 3 minus 1 into 6 divided by 1, so that will be 0. So this is our special case 1. So we have got 0 in the first column of roots array. See, we have the value 0 in the first column of the roots array. So this is our special case 1. So after that the values will be 0, and then we cannot calculate the further values. So here the root test will fail. So let us see what to do in such type of cases. See, the following method is used to remove the above said difficulty if we are to substitute a small positive number epsilon in place of the 0 occurred as first element in a row and complete the array with this number epsilon. Then examine the sign change by taking the limit as epsilon tends to 0. So let us see. We have replaced the 0 with epsilon. By replacing this with epsilon, we will get the next value as 1.5, then 0. Okay, so we have already got that 1.5 and 0. Then next is we have to calculate next term, that is d1, from the values 2, 6, epsilon and 1.5. So to calculate that, we will take 6 epsilon minus 2 into 1.5 divided by epsilon, and it comes 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon. Then by calculation of next term, it will be 1, then 0. Then calculate the next row values, that is 1.5 into 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon minus epsilon into 1 divided by 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon. Again the next values will be 0 and 0. If we calculate the next row, that is for s raised to 0, it will be 1. Okay, so in this way we will get these values. Now we have to take the limit as epsilon tends to 0. See here, to examine the sign change, we have to take the limit. So, limit as epsilon tends to 0 of 6 epsilon minus 3 divided by epsilon. So, here 6 is constant term. We have to take the limit for 3 upon epsilon and it will be infinity. So, 6 minus infinity will be minus infinity. So, put minus infinity in the roots array where the value is 6 epsilon minus 3 upon epsilon, that is in s raised to 2 row. Okay, then take the next term. So, the next term is 1.5 into 6 epsilon minus 3 minus epsilon square divided by 6 epsilon minus 3. So, take the limit for it. So, by taking the limit, we will get plus 1.5. So, put it in the roots array again. So, that is s raised to 1 row. Okay. Now our roots array is complete. Observe the roots array. Observe the first column of the roots array. And the elements in the first column are 1, 2, plus epsilon, minus infinity, plus 1.5 and 1. Observe the sign changes. So here the sign is changed 2 times from plus epsilon to minus infinity. And second times minus infinity to plus 1.5. So, since there are 2 sign changes in the first column of the roots array, the system is unstable. We can also predict that there will be 2 poles at the right side of the S plane. Okay, when the system is unstable, the poles are at the right side of the S plane. So, here there will be 2 poles at the right side of the S plane since there are 2 sign changes. Next example. Consider a system with characteristic equation s raised to 5 plus 2 s raised to 4 plus 2 s cube plus 4 s raised to 2 plus 11 s plus 10 is equal to 0. Determine the stability using roots criteria. First, we have to write down the equation, characteristic equation, and find the even and odd coefficients from the characteristic equation. Okay, then form the roots array. It will start as s raised to 5, then s raised to 4, s raised to 3, s raised to 2, s raised to 1 and s raised to 0. Then write down the coefficient. So, coefficient of s raised to 5 is 1. Then coefficient of s raised to 3 is 2. Then coefficient of s is 11. In the next row, coefficient of s raised to 4 is 2. Coefficient of s raised to 2 is 4 and coefficient of s raised to 0 is 10. Okay, now we have to calculate the next values. So, for calculating the value of C1, we will be having the equation like this. 2 into 2 minus 1 into 4 divided by 2. So, it will become 0. Again, there is 0 in the first column of the roots array. So, this is special case 1. And as we have seen, for this we have to substitute a small value epsilon in the place of 0 and then calculate the roots array and then determine the sign changes by taking the limit as epsilon tends to 0. So, let us do this. Substitute a small positive number epsilon in place of 0 occurred as first element in the row. Complete the array with this number epsilon and then examine the sign change by taking limit as epsilon tends to 0. So, let us put epsilon in the s raised to 3 row. So, it will become epsilon 6 0. Then calculate the next value and it will be 4 epsilon minus 12 divided by epsilon. Okay, then the next value will be 10, 0. In the next row, 24 epsilon minus 72 minus 10 epsilon square divided by 4 epsilon minus 12, 0, 0. And in the s raised to 0 row, 10, 0, 0. Okay, so now to examine the sign change, we have to take the limit. So, first we will take the limit for 4 epsilon minus 12 divided by epsilon. So, that will become infinity since epsilon is in the denominator, the value of this will be infinity by taking the limit as 0. Next, take the limit as epsilon tends to 0 of 24 epsilon minus 72 minus 10 epsilon square divided by 4 epsilon minus 12. So, by taking the limit, we will get this value as 6. Now, put the values in the roots array. So, the finally array becomes 1 to 11, 2, 4, 10, epsilon, 6, 0, infinity, 10, 0, 6, 0, 0, 10, 0, 0. Observe the first column of the roots array and there is no sign change in the first column. So, the system is stable. Next example. Consider the sixth order system with characteristic equation s raised to 6 plus 2 s raised to 5 plus 8 s raised to 4 plus 12 s cube plus 20 s square plus 16 s plus 16 is equal to 0. Determine the stability of system using roots criteria. Here, sixth order system is set, so that means highest power of this characteristic equation is 6, so it is called as sixth order system. So, let us write down the characteristic equation first, and it is f of s is equal to s raised to 6 plus 2 s raised to 5 plus 8 s raised to 4 plus 12 s raised to 3 plus 20 s square plus 16 s plus 16 is equal to 0. Then the coefficients, that is even coefficients, are a 0, a 2, a 4, a 6, that is 1, 8, 20, 16. Then odd coefficients, that is a 1, a 3, a 5, are 2, 12, 16 respectively. Next step is to form the roots array. So for the roots array, we will take the s raised to 6, s raised to 5, s raised to 4, s raised to 3, s raised to 2, s raised to 1, s raised to 0 on the left side and then write down the coefficients. So even coefficients first in the first row and that are 1, 8, 20, 16. Then in the second row, odd coefficients 2, 12, 16, 0. Then calculate the values for the next row and they will come 2, 12, 16, 0 like this. Okay. Now see, in the next row, when we calculate the values for all places in this row are 0. So see, it is the special case 2 in which the values of all elements in a row are 0. See what to do in this case. We have to form an auxiliary equation of the row which is just above the row of 0. So observe the row which is just above the row of 0, it is having the values as 2, 12, 16, 0. I have underlined it. Okay, so from this we will form the auxiliary equation as a of s is equal to 2 s raised to 4 plus 12 s square plus 16 is equal to 0. See how it is written. Since these values are in the row of s raised to 4, the first value will be having s raised to 4, that is 2 s raised to 4. Then we have to take next even power, that is s raised to 2. So the term will be plus 12 s raised to 2. And the next even power term is s raised to 0. So 16 s raised to 0 is only 16. So our auxiliary equation becomes 2 s raised to 4 plus 12 s square plus 16. Now take the derivative of it, d by ds of a of s. So that will be d by ds of 2s raised to 4 plus 12 square plus 16. Now, derivative of 2s raised to 4 is 8s cube. Then derivative of 12 square is 24s, and derivative of constant term, that is 16, is 0. So it becomes 8s cube plus 24s plus 0. Now we have to place it in place of zeros. Okay, so that is s raised to 3 row. So our roots array will become like this. So we have put in the s raised to 3 row the coefficients as 8, 24, 0. Okay, then calculate the next values and they will come 6, 16, 0. In the next row 2.66, 0. And lastly in the s raised to 0th row 16. So now observe the first column of the roots array as all elements in the first column of the roots array are having the having same sign, or there is no sign change, the system is stable. Next example. Using roots criteria, determine the range of k values for system to be stable, and g of s into h of s is given as k divided by s into s plus 2, s plus 4, s plus 5. The characteristic equation of transfer function is given by 1 plus g of s into h of s is equal to 0. See what is the example. It is given that the system is stable, okay, and one equation of g of s into h of s is given. In that there is k term, and we have to determine the range of k values, okay, within what range the value of k will be, we have to determine it. So the characteristic equation of the transfer function is given as 1 plus g of s into h of s is equal to 0 as per the block diagram of the closed loop control system. So recall that block diagram in which the characteristic equation of transfer function is given by 1 plus g of s into h of s is equal to 0. So let us substitute the value of g of s into h of s into this. So it will become 1 plus k divided by s into s plus 2 into s plus 4 into s plus 5 is equal to 0. So evaluate this, you will get s into s plus 2, s plus 4, s plus 5 plus k is equal to 0. Further solving it, you will get the equation as s raised to 4 plus 11 s cube plus 38 s square plus 40s plus k is equal to 0. So let us determine the coefficients from this. First coefficient, a0 is equal to 1, a1 is equal to 11, a2 is equal to 38, a3 is equal to 40, and a4 is equal to k. Now we have to form roots array from these coefficients. So here is the roots array. In this, at the left side, we have taken s raised to 4, s raised to 3, s raised to 2, s raised to 1, and s raised to 0. Then the values for the first two rows are written. Next value is calculated as
11 into 38 minus 1 minus 1 into 40 divided by 11, that comes 34.36. Next value comes k, then 0. Then in the next row, 1374.4 minus 11k divided by 34.36. Next value is 0. And in the last row, the value is k. For the stability of a system, there should be no change in sign. So we already know that the system is stable. Okay, so there should not be sign change. That is 1374.4 minus 11k divided by 34.36 should be greater than 0, and hence k greater than 0. Or we can write 1374.4 minus 11k divided by 34.36 should be greater than 0. That is 1374.4 minus 11k should be greater than 0. It gives us 1374.4 should be greater than 11k. By equating this, we will get maximum value of k should be less than 124.94. So combining these both conditions for stability, we will get the range of values of k will be in between 0 and 124.94.